If you had the chance to build your dream enduro race bike, what would it be and how would you set it up? My name is Brian Kale, and in season 2 of Let's Go Racing, I'll be doing exactly that. I've gone into this season with no component sponsors. This will allow me to test and choose the components that I think will help me perform at my best. I've acquired a wide range of products from some of the best brands on the market, and I'll be doing shootout videos for suspension, brakes, wheels, and cockpit setups. I think the needs of an EWS racer are a little different than your average consumer, and I hope to give you guys insight into these products from a racer's perspective. The Forbidden Dreadnought will be my race bike of choice for the year, as well as my test mule, and once I've decided on my final bike setup, I'll be taking it racing at the 3 North American EWS rounds, as well as TransBC. I hope I can give you guys insight into what it takes to compete at the highest level from a privateer's perspective, and I hope that through sharing my story, I can help you guys out with aspects of your own riding and racing. We're gonna have the testing video starting to drop here in the next week, and I really look forward to nerding out with you guys and bringing you guys along for the ride for the rest of the season. It's shaping up to be a hectic year, and I really hope you enjoy the rest of the series. So we're out here in Oliver Springs, Tennessee, just a short 15-minute drive from the Windrock Bike Park. We're actually at Dakota Norton's place right now. He's sponsoring our trailer parking spot for the first part of the season. I've been out here for about a month and a half now. Quit my job in California and committed to living in this full-time on the road this season. So it was a bit of a hectic week getting out here. Definitely some drama with getting this thing on the road for the first time, but now we're settled in and it's been sweet. This thing's got all the amenities of home. We've got a garage, kitchen, living room, shower. The races I've taken it to, it's been such a luxury. It's like, usually I'm used to not showering for 4 days, scrambling for food and everything. So that was kind of the goal with this, is just to have myself like be really set up and dialed at the races. I think being out here at Windrock is gonna be a big help for me this season, especially spending so much time out here early in the year. Like, I don't think there's anywhere else in the country that's running shuttles 7 days a week. So just the amount of riding I've been able to get in early in the season has been way more than I've ever been able to do in the past. And the trails on the West Coast that I've been used to, they're super fun, and I think they are challenging in ways, but just the terrain on the East Coast is way different. It's way more technical, way more demanding on the bike, and I think it's just consistently steeper, rootier, and rougher. So in the past, I felt like I've come into the first races of the season that are real gnarly, like pretty unprepared and off the back, and I feel like I've been able to address a lot of the issues I've felt at those first races, like here at Windrock already. We'll be heading to Missouri in a couple weeks after we wrap up filming for the testing, and from there we'll be hitting EWS's, some trans races, and we'll take you guys to the season. Today we're going to be talking about wheels. I'll be going into the advantages and disadvantages of each wheel and telling you guys what I'll be running on this year's race bike.